Namaste viewers, welcome to Avinash Bio category. In the last video we focused on how that a genetic material was being searched. So in the earlier time, how the scientists came to know so which molecule is considered to be the exact genetic material in the cell. So after this one, if you want to focus on that DNA, we are having some important process related to that DNA. So Crick already he mentioned the central dogma related to this molecular biology. So here the central dogma, what it suggests, the central molecule is our DNA, and the DNA is going to produce the mRNA, single stranded mRNA, that is transcription. That produce single stranded mRNA or the RNA, that is next, further it is going to produce the protein, that is polypeptide chain, and that the second next process is considered to be the translation. And in the same DNA producing another DNA copy, then that process is considered to be the replication. So replication, transcription, translation, these are the three basic processes, so which are at most fundamental assets for the life to be lived. So here, if we consider such kind of first important process related to the DNA, so major physiological, metabolical reaction or activity related to the DNA. So I hope in 2015 onwards, whatever the previous year question papers we want to observe, if you analyze the NEET question papers regarding this particular chapter, so there maximum questions, most of the years maximum questions have been asked from this replication concept only. So this is at most important concept. So today let us focus on that replication concept. I don't know still whether it becomes a one video or whether I have to make the video in two parts or two sessions, still I don't know, but this is a vast concept. So today let me try, today I'll explain the fundamental materials or the enzymatic requirements for this replication process to occur. So I think today video will be interesting. So shall we start? Yes. So here, if we consider the major process, replication. Yes. So in the general sense, if I want to explain this one, if I want to elaborate in the general sense, means just a doubling of DNA or multiplying the copies of DNA or just increasing the number of DNA, number of copies of DNA. Or in another meaning, xeroxing of DNA. Yes, of course, we are having one master copy of DNA. That master copy has to be xeroxed. So that xeroxing process is considered to be the replication. So this is the utmost important process here. And here, it is totally controlled by the enzymatic machinery here. So if you want to consider here, the replication, it may be conservative or semi-conservative. So what is the meaning of conservative means? Conservative means as it is transferring there to the next generation. So whatever the DNA present in the parental cell or mother cell, the total DNA content as it is getting transferred to the next generation, that is conservative. That means both the DNA strands as it is transferred to the daughter cell. But another step is there, another process is there, another type, that is semi-conservative. Semi-conservative means in both the DNA strand, that is the DNA is a double stranded, both the strands get separated, and the separated DNA strands, we will refer them as a template DNA strands. So those are template DNA strands, 50-50% both the strands, they enter into the two daughter cells. That means the producing daughter cell will receive only half of the DNA strand. Another half of the DNA strand is newly synthesized. Hence, that process is considered to be the, that style is considered to be the semi-conservative. So here, today let me focus on the majorly semi-conservative mode of DNA replication. Yes, so DNA replication is a semi-conservative. That is in all the cells, sorry, that is in all the DNA concerned, is majorly. So here it is semi-conservative, and here usually DNA replication occurs at S page of cell division. That means in the cell cycle we are having some stages, gap on page or growth on page, yes page, G2 page, then M page. So there in the S page particularly, yes means synthesis. What is the synthesis here? DNA synthesis. DNA synthesis is nothing but replication. It occurs in the S page. So this is the major step here. And here if you consider this a DNA replication, it is a little bit difference. It is a quite a difference in case of prokaryotes as well as eukaryotes here. Right? So here if I consider in the prokaryotes, DNA replication in prokaryotes. So why it is different means, as already we know, prokaryotes do not have the nuclear membrane. The whatever the DNA content is there in the prokaryote cell, the, for example in bacteria, we will refer that to total DNA content as a nucleide. So that nucleide is not surrounded by the nuclear membrane. That means there is no separation of cytoplasm and nucleoplasm. But in case of eukaryotes, so the DNA content which has to be doubled, which is undergoing the replication, that is surrounded by the nuclear membrane. Hence, cytoplasm content is little bit, cytoplasm content is separated from this nucleoplasm content. Hence, the machinery, the enzymatic machinery is quite different both in prokaryotes as well as eukaryotes. So, enzymes means, I am talking about the enzymes are responsible for replication process. Right? So, in the prokaryotes, here, this is considered to be the simple process. As well as this is faster process in most of the prokaryotes. Why it is simple means, as already we know, the organization itself is simple. And second thing, so this is the fast process. Why it is fast process means, in the prokaryotes, usually DNA length is less compared to eukaryotic cells. And say for example, if I consider E. coli cell, right? If I consider E. coli cell DNA length is 4.6 into 10 to the power 6 base pairs. So total number of base pairs in the E. coli DNA. Then for this DNA to replicate, so this amount of DNA to double, it will take 19 minutes. That means nearly 20 minutes. So E. coli replication, E. coli cell division time is 20 minutes. There 19 minutes time is taken by just to double this amount of DNA, this much length of DNA. That means time is short here. And because of that reason also, so usually division period in prokaryotic cell is fast. They are going to divide rapidly here. And here, if the time taken is 19 minutes, means roughly we can say here, 2000 base pairs, so divided, 2000 base pairs are added per second. So what I am saying here is, per second 2000 base pairs are formed in the DNA. In that speed, if it is formed, means within 19 minutes this much of DNA is doubled. So this is in case of the E. coli cell, that is in case of the prokaryotes. And here in the prokaryotes we are having some enzymes, the important enzymes. Enzymes are needed for this replication in case of prokaryotes. So here usually three major enzymes are present here. The first one is DNA dependent. Okay, let me write here. Of course the enzyme is a DNA dependent, but I will write simply here, DNA polymerase 1, right? And the second one is DNA polymerase 2, and the third one is DNA polymerase 3. So we are having the three enzymes responsible for overall replication in prokaryotes. Polymerase 1, 2, 3, and all these are depending on DNA. That is a DNA dependent DNA polymerases. So here, if we consider their individual functions, DNA polymerase 1, its a major work is proofreading major repair. I think here the so ink is empty. Yes. So it's a major work is a proofreading and major repair. So what is the meaning of proofreading here? Proofreading means in the total DNA strand, that is in a total double strand DNA strand. Usually double stranded DNA present in the wind form. It is present in the helical wind form. And the first during the DNA replication, the both strands which are winded, so both are going to separate. After the separation, new strands are formed. And when the new nucleotides are going to add, in what speed they are adding? 2000. 2000 nucleotides are added per second. That means the speed is very huge, tremendous speed. So in that speed, if the nucleotides are adding continuously, there may be chance of addition of wrong nucleotide. When wrong nucleotides are added, then the property of that segment where the wrong nucleotide is added, so that DNA portion becomes waste. That means it becomes mutated. It will not work properly. Then what to do? We have to remove that repair, that unwanted nucleotide. That means if you want to remove that one, means once we have to read that one. So that reading is considered to be the proofreading. So say for simply, suppose if you want to type, so any text that what we have written, so handwritten, so that text we are going to type by using our computer or laptop. After the typing, once we have to read it, whether is there any mistake. So that reading is considered to be the proofreading. Like that nucleotides, once they are readed, whether the nucleotides are properly joined or not. So that process is considered to be the proofreading. This proofreading and as well as a major repair. So if there any repair means that major repair done by the DNA polymerase one here. And here, if we consider the proofreading here, this portion particularly, proofreading. So you may wonder here, just one base pair per 1 billion base pairs. See the ratio here. Per 1 billion base pair, there may be chance of one defective base pair or one nucleotide. That means in the DNA, if 1 billion nucleotides are joined, out of 1 billion, there may be chance of one base pair wrong. That means that much of accuracy is there while joining the nucleotides. And that repair is done by here, this enzyme. And this DNA polymerase 2, if I consider, so DNA polymerase 2, its work is again repair. And this repair is minor repair. This one major repair and minor repair. But overall thing, polymerase 1 and polymerase 2, their work is repairing of DNA. Right? And the last one, if you consider DNA polymerase 3, DNA polymerase 3 is polymerization of nucleotides. So what it indicates? Nucleotides are added on the old strand of DNA, new strand of DNA should be formed. That is by joining the nucleotides one by one. That process is done by DNA polymerase 3. So this is the actual enzyme of that replication process. This is the main enzyme. And after this enzyme work, these two enzymes are going to repair that any fault in the DNA. That is in the new strand of the DNA. So these three enzymes are majorly used. Along with these three enzymes, some other proteins, some ions are used for this overall process to happen. And keep one thing in your mind, this total replication process is energy requiring process. So this is totally depending on energy consuming process, right? So energy is needed, some proteins, special proteins are needed, some ions are needed, and all these three major enzymes are needed for replication in case of, that is in a prokaryotes. So this is the first thing here. So in a prokaryotes, this is the first one. And let me consider how this DNA replication specially occurring in eukaryotes. DNA replication in eukaryotes. So this is quite different here. So why I am telling the quite difference means, if I consider the first beginning enzyme machinery in case of eukaryotes, so there 5 major enzymes are used, right? Let me write here. The first enzyme used is DNA polymerase alpha, and the second one is DNA polymerase beta, third one. DNA polymerase gamma, and the fourth one DNA polymerase delta. Okay, let me write here. And the fifth one DNA polymerase epsilon. So these are 5 major enzymes are used. Here 3 enzymes, there are 5 enzymes. So that is quite complex compared to this one, prokaryotic replication. So here, just consider DNA polymerase alpha. So its work is initiation of replication. So the replication process is initiated by that first enzyme, that is a DNA polymerase alpha. And if you consider DNA polymerase beta, so this enzyme work is repairing of DNA. So after the formation of new DNA strand, it helps in the repairing of DNA. That means proofreading also along with that one. And if you consider third one, DNA polymerase gamma, so its work is again repair of DNA. What type of DNA that is? Mitochondrial DNA. That is a special thing. Mitochondrial DNA. Of course, DNA is the mitochondria is the autonomous cell organelle we will consider. Why? Because it is having its own DNA. So that is in the present in the circular form. That circular DNA present in the mitochondria, it will also replicate. That replication, if any fault is there, means that is repaired by the third enzyme. That is alpha. That is gamma. And the fourth enzyme, if you consider DNA polymerase. So what it in the DNA polymerase delta, this is the actually polymerase enzyme. That means actual nucleotides, actual new strand is formed by this enzyme, DNA polymerase delta. And the last one, epsilon. So here the last one, epsilon work is, this is also same polymerase enzyme. It also acts as a polymerase enzyme, but thing is, in HeLa cells. So this is the most important thing. HeLa cells means these are the special cells. If they get mutated, means they will start to cause the tumor in the body. That means cancer cells, HeLa cells. That means cancer potential cells, those HeLa cells. So in those cells, this enzyme DNA polymerase epsilon, it helps in the adding of new nucleotides, that means formation of new DNA strand. So this is the replication enzyme in those cells, and this is the replication enzyme in normal cells. So what finally it indicates, these two enzymes are replicating enzymes, formation of new DNA strands, and these two enzymes are repairing enzymes, and the first enzyme helps in the initiation of replication, right? And one more thing, just you compare here, DNA polymerase 3, its work is equivalent to DNA polymerase delta in case of prokaryote, and that is in case of eukaryotes. And next, DNA polymerase 1 and 2, their work is equivalent to DNA polymerase alpha and beta. So, work is almost similar, but the thing is, here this side is a little bit simple process, this side it is some complicated process here. Right? And not only these enzymes, along with these enzymes, some other extra enzymes have been used. So, if you want to write, means take a screenshot of this one. Let me rub this one. Okay. Let me rub here. So here, just other enzymes, if you want to focus, other enzymes along with DNA polymerases in case of prokaryotes, if I consider. So in prokaryotes, other enzymes. Which are those other enzymes here? The first one major enzyme is DNA helicase. So DNA helicase, sometimes it is also called as DNA unwindase. So what is its work? So what are the name suggest here? Unwindase. Windase means just you think here, if two strands have been coiled here, like in this, twisted in this manner, like this. If both the strands have been twisted here, means we will consider this one as a winding. If it is cancelled, means if it is in the reverse order, means we will consider as unwinding. So that unwinding is done by DNA helicase. So we will also consider as a DNA unwindase. Say for example, so imagine this is our DNA, right? Or the prokaryotic DNA. So the DNA present in the wind form now. Now at one place it is, so say for example here, let us consider at this place the hydrogen bonds which are present at center, those hydrogen bonds are going to break. After breaking, the strand is going to stretch out, the strands are going to separate. So the separation occurs like this, right? So here the strand is going to separate, both the strands are separating, and this central portion is looking like our eye. So it is also referred as a replication eye or replication fork. If I observe this one from just half of this center side, it's look like Y. So replication fork or replication eye. And here the unwinding process occurs in both the direction, both in this direction and in this direction also. So this is a bidirectional process, and that work is done by DNA helicase, the first one. And here, imagine, of course, the strands are going to open, but the problem arises there. What is the problem? Imagine if this is our DNA. What is the total length of our DNA? That is total 2.2 meter DNA we are having. For us, that 2.2 meter is less. That length is less compared to us. But compared to enzymes, that is a huge length. Say for example, how the light year distance is for us, in that sense, 2.2 meter, that total overall length of DNA is used for the enzymes. Now, if you make just one cut in the DNA and the DNA wants to be unwind in either direction, so here the separation process moves to certain distance away from the starting point. So here a tension is created, this side and here. The tension gets created. What is the tension? Just you observe, just you do that thing, take any winded wires and you start separating from one point just. So after certain distance at one place, that winded form will not unlock. That means a tension is created. So here also tension is created. To avoid that tension, here next enzyme is used. That enzyme is DNA topoisomerase Murrays, or it is also called as DNA gyrase. So DNA topoisomerase or DNA gyrase. So its work is breaking off sulfur and phosphate bonds. Sugar and phosphate bonds. That means in the nucleotides, that is in the backbone of the DNA, we are having phosphodiester bonds. Those phosphodiester bonds are broken down by this DNA topoisomerase or DNA gyrase. And after breaking those bonds, once again it will rejoin it. After cutting, whatever the tension, whatever the pressure is present in the opening DNA strands, that pressure is released and once again it will rejoin there. That means pressure is eradicated, that is pressure is over. So that work is done by the second enzyme. And next third enzyme is DNA so instead of considering this one, let me consider a protein. This is not the enzyme, protein, SSB protein, and it is also having utmost important role during this process. Say here, say for example, this is the DNA strand, right? Now the DNA strand get separated here. Now the strand is separated here. Now there is a chance of again curling off these DNA strands because of that pressure. So that pressure is prevented by the second enzyme. And one more thing, there may be chance of again rejoining of both the strands. So in order to avoid that one, someone has to hold the DNA strands from either side. So that process done by some special proteins, and those proteins get attached on both the sides. And these special proteins attached on the both the single strands are called as single-stranded binding proteins. Single-stranded binding proteins. Their work is holding both the strands apart. Yes, so that is the that one. And one more enzyme is there here. That is one more major enzyme. So that is DNA ligase. Ligating means joining here. DNA ligase work is joining the cut strands of DNA. In the DNA, during DNA replication, if there is any cut in between the DNA strands, so that is joined by the DNA ligase, and it is majorly joining the Okazaki fragments. Right? And what are these Okazaki fragments? We will come to know it later. So these are Okazaki fragments, and keep one thing in your mind, Okazaki fragments get produced on the lagging strand. Produced in the lagging strand. In the lagging strand, these Okazaki fragments, in between the Okazaki fragments, there will be gap. So that gap is filled by this DNA ligase, right? And it is also called as molecular stitcher. It will stitch the gap. And okay, this is the molecular stitcher. And who is the molecular scissor? So the molecular scissor is a DNA, that restriction endonuclease enzymes or nuclease enzymes. Nuclease enzymes are scissors, ligases are stitchers, cutting and joining. Yes, so its work is opposite to that enzyme. And one more thing, I told you, along with these enzymes, some special ions are used, that is Mg plus 2 ions. Right, and these Mg plus 2 ions, they are acting as the promoter portion of the enzymes. So they help in acting as a cofactors, right? Cofactors in case of the so many enzymes. And along with this one, as usual, we know the ATP molecules are used. Why? Because this is the energy requiring process. So these many enzymes. So some different proteins, ions, all the together act in an accurate manner, in the very fast manner, to double the total DNA content. And here, how does the DNA content is going to double, how the actual replication process occurs, during replication process, what are the steps going to occur over there, and how the processes occur step by step. So let us see the whole thing in the next video. Right? Thank you.